And welcome back to my playthrough of the game Cradle. This is Technix, and we are just getting ready to. I found the right book, and I am reading the parable right now. And this is going to take me to the keys to the chests so that I can find out about my parents. I was looking at this wrong book, and now I found the right book. It's this one. So, collection of Neo-Buddhist fables, short morality tales. One of them is carefully circled with a marker. Sitarasana's path. One night in the woods, a girl named Sitarasana had a curious thought. She suddenly realized that she didn't know who her parents were. It can't be that I don't have parents. I must have simply forgotten them. I bet they're waiting for me back home, thought the girl. Pardon me, which way do I go to find my parents' home? Sitarasana asked a vagrant with a malcontent face. If you don't know where to go, go towards the light. That's what I always do, the vagrant replied, shaking soot off his smoking head. Okay. Sitarasana looked about herself to the east, rays of the rising sun were filtering through the tree trunks. My home must be that way. The girl decided and headed toward the light. So the first way is going to be the sun. The sun guided her path that entire day, but then evening came and it hid behind the horizon. The moon rose to the firmament. The girl halted momentarily, wavering, then shrugged and started after the moon. So the moon is going to be second. By come morning, the moon melted from the sky, replaced once more by the sun. Sitarasana frowned and then turned toward the sun. We'll walk until I reach my goal, she decided. Sun. 6 days and six nights, Sitarasana wandered through the woods, alternating between the sun and the moon and changing direction until she reached a meadow flooded with phantasmal light. Beg pardon, but where is the light coming from? I see neither the sun nor the moon in the sky, she asked the Buddha, who was listening to the music streaming from her radio speaker. Buddha stuck his finger in the sky and returned. Buddha stuck his finger in the sky and returned the volume knob to its former position. The girl looked up and saw the stars above. She smiled and thought, what beautiful music. Okay, so I'm guessing that since it said that she alternated, starting with the sun, that's what I'm supposed to do. So what I'm going to do is head back out here to the grave and get my flashlight out. And I am going to alternate till I get there. So sun, moon, sun, moon. That would be funny if it took me back home. Where's... not seeing a new one. So she kept going. I don't know if this is right. Alright. I'm gonna do this one more time and I'm going to follow a better path here. Starting with the sun. Okay. So, moon. And it hits this. So I did the moon. Now I'm gonna do the sun. Okay. kind of line up here so I don't like miss it. Okay, I think I'm going too fast. Oh, there it is. Alright. So that was sun, moon, sun, moon. Jesus. Alright, I think I'm like off track here. It's easy to like get off of a straight line. Oh boy, I'm gonna do this one more time. Actually, I'm probably gonna end up doing it more than once, I'm sure. If this gets to be a pain, I'll cut it and come back after I've done it. Alright, that's one, but I'm not gonna just start here. Okay. Okay, so it said wait a minute, because it said that she alternated, but it also said for six days, so I'm wondering if that means I have to do like six of those. I'll walk until I reach my goal. Okay, so sun, moon, sun. Okay. So yeah, it's gonna be just alternating. It's probably six times, because it says 6 days and six nights. So I don't know if that means after the original three or including the original three, but I am going to start with that. Hopefully if I can keep track of these. Okay, so sun. Moon, sun, okay, sun. Oh, God, you know, I get trigger happy with my finger here, and wow, I just lost my. Did I really just lose that? Oh, there it is. Alright. Jeez. It's on the first trigger, or first mouse button, and my mouse is a little sensitive. So I'm going with the sun, and I hit this. So now I want to go with the moon. This would be four. So I want to go that way, okay. I'm going to take this slow. There we go. So that was the moon. Now we're going to do the sun. Oh, there it is. And then we're going to do the moon. Okay. So then maybe it is six more. Okay, so this, I did six, so I need three more. No, four. 6 days. So five. Wait, hold on. Sun, moon. Or was it? Shoot. Okay, I'm just gonna keep alternating. Is that right? And the sun. I guess I'm just gonna keep going. It said 6 days, but I've done more than that. This is the last one. Well, that's okay. Dang it. So, I don't know if that means I'm supposed to keep going. I know the question, but I think I'm off track again. Oh boy. Yeah. Alright. I am going to... Yeah. I'm gonna have to play with this. And I got the... I mean, I got the little pop-up, so I think I was on the right track, but... I'm having a little bit of trouble with this. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut here, and then I will be right back to see... oh, wait. Who am I? There we go. I was probably standing right on top of it. Okay, I'm not going to do that. Who am I? Oh my god, really? It is pointing directly at home. Oh. Is it this box? You know, Here you find the answer to your question. Who am I? That's right, Enabish. Who am I is the question that leads to the secret of your past. You are but a step away from unraveling the mystery, from the ancient, mystifying events whose meaning I never did grasp till the end of my days. Perhaps you are you are destined to reveal their divine plan. I promised you a key to the chest that store your parents' belongings. The key is before you, and with it I pass you. Oh, I'm sorry. And with it I pass you that which I had guarded in my memory for many years. Yes, the things in the chest belong to Zambul and Sarne. However, these people are not your parents or even your relatives. They had a son of their own once, but he had died in that explosion under the dome. He was 5 years old and his name was Chagatai. Several days after the explosion, a golden eagle arrived here carrying a human infant. He set the child down on the ground in front of the yurt. You were that infant, Anubish. Who you are and where you came from, I do not know. From that day, the home of my late son became a haven for you and Ongans. I was not repulsed by the strange appearance of your bodies. Who am I to pass judgment on Providence? Dismay came a month later when Chattagai's features on your face became unmistakable. Goodbye forever, your grandfather Badgen. This is really weird. Okay, so I want the key, and I definitely want the empty envelope. Oh, that must have been the letter or something. Oh, it's just a mailbox, so it's an empty. Okay. New task added. Search the chests. Alright, I don't know if this is the last chapter or not. I think this is the last chapter, so I'm just going to run over. I don't need to start a new episode for this. Upper chest is too heavy. Okay. It's a TV of some sort. Alright. Looks like a saddle of some sort. I think I'm just emptying this chest out and then I'm going to the bottom chest. And a radio. I'll just set this here. Still kind of want to know what that thing is for. There's just a bunch of pulling stuff out of here. Come on now. Is there supposed to actually be something in here that's... Boots. Packs of letters, one correspondence, Mr. Mark Anita. I've already written you about him. He works nearby at the station. Well, a few years back, he'd met a girl. He says they saw each other only once in a company of friends. And somehow, the way she looked at him, he's been dreaming of that moment ever since. Mark speaks of some strange sensation called the Babylonian effect, and that the entire institute is studying it at the present. Zambul and I laughed in return. The sensation is totally normal, Mark. We've studied it thoroughly long ago. Kick your science to the curb and go to Ida before she gets her body replaced. Task at it. I think I'm supposed to talk to Ida. Yep.
I found it. You and Mark had met once before.
Yes. I already know. I remembered it.
Mark was recalling some kind of special moment.
Nothing so special that it stayed with me. Except maybe there was this strange sensation.
A sensation?
Yes. Sometimes I get a peculiar feeling. It somehow resembles anxiety, but only partially. I can't really describe it. It is a sad, pleasant feeling. I had felt it again that particular evening, and...
And what?
Anibish, I'm about to shut down.
Wait. We're not done figuring out your past.
And we won't. I am out of time. I... received a message.
From whom?
From my neurochip. Only, the neurochip writes in red letters. I'm being informed that it is self-destructing. Know what I can do?
What?
Split myself in two.
What do you mean?
When I shut down, my upper half will split from my legs.
Why?
I've no clue. That's just how my body works. I can show you. Watch.
Wait, don't. Ida, listen.
I'm listening.
Maybe there's still a way to fix everything.
Fix everything? Well, there is a way. If you can travel to the past and pass 4 digits to Professor Koch, that would fix everything. Fix everything.
Dang. Okay, you know what, actually, I am going to cut this here, because I don't know how much is left, but there's some, I really am running over time, so, I'll be right back with, maybe the conclusion, we'll see. So, I hope you're liking it, and, shock with electricity for, oh, because I need to do that, okay. Hope you're liking it, like, subscribe, and I will be back next time. Thank you.